Welcome to the KNFB Reader Online School. I'm James Gashel. Grab a seat, grab your reader, let's get started. In this lesson, we're going to learn about the KNFB Reader Settings menu. We'll have to launch the reader to do that, so here we go.
KNFB Reader, take picture, button.
And as always, we're right back at the take picture screen in KNFB Reader. And next to the File Explorer, which is in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, we'll find the Settings option.
Settings.
So I swiped left, from the left-hand side of the screen to the right-hand side of the screen. One swipe, one finger swipe, and I've got Settings. I'll double tap.
Settings. Back button.
Now I've got quite a few different settings options, and we're not going to cover the details of all of them. You can do that on your own just to help you explore. So,
settings, heading.
So, that's a heading at the beginning. That's the settings.
Camera, heading.
And that's a camera settings is the first sort of subhead under settings.
Flashlight is always on. Switch button.
Okay, and you could turn the flashlight. So you had a flashlight on. It might be good for people with low vision during in using it, the reader in low light. But normally we would leave the flashlight off. Besides, it chews up batteries, so you may not want to turn it on unless you have a power source to keep the reader powered up.
Field of view landscape mode. Switch button.
You can change how the field of view report works. Field of view report is a way of lining up a picture. We covered that in another lesson. And you could use field of view report in landscape or portrait mode. Normally, we would leave this off.
Field of view reports visible corners. Switch button. Select recognition languages. Button.
Select recognition languages means choose any other language that the reader reads. We're obviously listening in English, but you could read in other languages.
Reader, heading. Automatically start reading. Switch button, on.
Automatically start reading. Now, that's a good one to use because the reader will begin to read text as soon as text is available to read. But if you want to control when the reader begins speaking the text, you can turn this off and then use the play pause button, the play button at the beginning after a picture is taken. Press the play button and the reader will begin reading text. As a matter of fact, the focus goes immediately to the play button, so it just requires an extra double tap for text to begin reading.
Allow reading in background. Switch button. On.
Allow reading in background means that if you close the reader, it will continue to speak if it has been reading text.
Allow word highlighting. Switch button. Off.
Highlighting simply means that for visual readers, a cursor moves through the text while reading, and the word that is being read is being spoken is also visible.
Speech volume, 80%.
And you can adjust the speech volume up or down. If you think it's too loud, turn it down a little bit.
Speech rate, 16%.
You can change the speech rate to make it very, very fast, which I know a number of you will do, or you can keep it kind of slow, which is sort of the way I do it.
Select reading languages.
You can change the reading languages.
File Explorer, heading.
You can go to the File Explorer. This is a heading, so
confirm before deleting. Switch button, on.
If you are deleting files from the File Explorer, obviously you have the option for a confirmation pop-up before the delete takes effect.
Dropbox backup, heading.
So you can link your File Explorer to Dropbox. Eventually, maybe other things as well, like Google Drive or Microsoft's OneDrive. But right now, Dropbox, which is a pretty universal file sharing source available in the cloud. And so you can link KNFB Reader to Dropbox. So you can actually set it, if you enable this link, so that whenever you take and save an image, that it all goes to Dropbox. And not only the file, but the image of the document, the whole thing, just as it appears in your File Explorer, it will also appear in a folder in your Dropbox account, and that folder will be called KNFB. And that's where you would find all of your Dropbox files.
Allow mobile data for Dropbox.
Switch. Allow mobile data, meaning that would happen whether you were connected using your data plan or Wi-Fi, that your files would go to Dropbox.
Back up all KNFB files to Dropbox.
Button. You can back up all of your KNFB files to Dropbox, meaning you can manually do that. I could do it right now, and it would take anything from my File Explorer and send it in a zip archive folder to my KNFB folder in Dropbox.
Restore all KNFB files from Dropbox.
So let's say you have used KNFB Reader and for some reason had to reinstall it, and you don't have anything in your KNFB Reader File Explorer directory, but it's all in the Dropbox. You can restore whatever was in your File Explorer as of whenever you did the last backup. You can restore that to your File Explorer from Dropbox. So you can go both ways, to Dropbox and from Dropbox.
Selected, General, Text, Tab, 2 of 3.
Now you've got several settings under Text. So we've really just covered the General. Under the Text, you can go through that on your own, but you can modify the size of the print. You can modify the color of the background.
About, Tab,
and now we're at, so you can change the color of the highlighting under the text. You can do a lot. So the screen appearance appears quite different. You can all do that under the Text tab. And under the About tab, you can learn the version of KNFB Reader and view all the legal disclosures of the licenses used for some of the software that is found in KNFB Reader. So the settings menu gives you a way of controlling your experience with KNFB Reader. It's really that simple. That's it for now, but please come back and see and hear some of our other lessons about the KNFB Reader here at our online school. KNFB Reader is brought to you through the joint efforts of the National Federation of the Blind in the United States and Sensotec in Belgium. Visit our website, knfbreader.com. Write to us at support@knfbreader.com. Follow us on Twitter @knfbreader or like us on Facebook. See you online. For KNFB Reader, I'm James Gashel.